In this lesson, we're going to talk about weak acids and bases. We're going to see how we write the equation representing a weak acid and distinguish between strong and weak acids and strong and weak bases. You are responsible for memorizing the six strong acids. If we know the six strong acids, we know that any other acids are weak. So when we look at strong acids and bases, the reason that they're called strong acids and strong bases is that they completely dissociate in water like a strong electrolyte. And in fact, they are strong electrolytes. So we show an example here with HCl, which is one of our six strong acids, and it completely dissociates into H plus and Cl minus. If we had a strong base like sodium hydroxide, NaOH, we would see that it completely dissociates into Na plus and OH minus. When we have weak acids and bases, what we see is that those are weak electrolytes, meaning they do not dissociate completely in water. When we see those, we see our equilibrium arrow, which again, remember, that is the reaction running in the forward and the reverse direction until it gets to chemical equilibrium. So we see a partial dissociation. And when we look at the K values of weak acids and weak bases, what we see is that those K values are relatively small, indicating that our HF is the species present in a much larger amount, because what we're seeing are values that are much, much less than 1, 10 to the minus 5, 10 to the minus 6, and so on. And so we have very little of our ions. The majority of those will stay intact as HF molecules in this case, or a weak base such as NH3 will stay as the NH3. A small portion will form the ions. So this table summarizes what we've seen about strong and weak acids, strong bases, and weak bases, and helps you learn how to identify which one falls into which category. So the easiest are the strong acids. There are six of them, and there are only six of them, so we memorize this list. As a result, that lets us figure out that any other acid is going to be a weak acid. So HF, H2S, these typically start with a hydrogen, except for water. The other type of weak acid we see in all of our organic acids, our weak acids, is that they contain a carboxylic acid functional group, so COOH. So here we have acetic acid where we have CH3COOH. Remember that that doesn't mean we have two oxygens bonded together. That COOH represents that functional group. For strong bases, what we see is that things that have our hydroxide ion, so a metal hydroxide, a potassium hydroxide, we will not see something, this is often confused, like CH3OH. That is not a strong base because while we have this OH group, we do not have a metal. And so this is not classified as a strong base. Our weak bases will be the amine compound. There are some others, but this is the main one we see. So NH3 substituting an H for a carbon chain. So basically anything with our NR3 format. And in this case, the R groups can be hydrogens or carbon chains.